You are watching Melody Lane. With me, you're gonna have a great crafting time.
Hi guys, it's Melody Lane. In my mystery box video, somebody asked for me to make the doghouse and a few other things, so I will probably make the teacup that was asked for. But first I'm starting with the doghouse because I was inspired, and I'm gonna make kind of a girly doghouse, and I added windows to the doghouse. So I will share this file with everyone who watches this video. This is from Tags, Bags, Boxes, and More 2. I created this. I had to slice out the roof, which is going to be purple today. I had to slice this out from here so I can make this as big as possible. So this is the biggest you can make it. And I'm using the new poster board. The new poster board only comes with one sheet of each color. If you want them the same color and you want it this big, one of these take up almost a whole piece of 12 by 12 poster board. But you could do them in different colors if you like. You'll have a bright looking house. Or you can do this out of cardstock. So here's what I'm doing today. The machine scores this. I cut out little holes. I already scored it, but I already bent it a little on this one, and I'll show you more on this one. Now this piece that gets folded over like the house, do not fold that tight down. Don't like smush it down, because then it starts to look like that, which it doesn't look horrible because that's going to be covered up anyway. There's no reason to put a huge crease in it because you're not going to need it there. I'm going to go over this because this is white core. So I'm just going to go over it with a colored marker. This is a Shinhan marker. It's an alcohol-based marker. The purple one I'm using is water-based. I just grab markers. I am going to do it around the windows. Again, this isn't something you have to do. Whoops. Messed up a little. I kind of do that in every video, don't I? Someone says to do it from underneath and you'll get it on the back and not on the front. You guys are so smart. You guys leave really good comments below telling me what to do sometimes. And I actually take your advice. I am not one of those people who think I know everything, because I know I don't. I just show you guys what I do. There's many ways, to do lots of things, and we all learn from each other, right? Just to kind of show you what this does, I already did this half of this one. I added this. This is from Ornamental Iron. You don't have to do this piece. If you don't own Ornamental Iron, I'm not even sure if it's in excess. If it's not, it'll charge you 99 cents for this file. Just delete this piece and then save it and you won't be charged the 99 cents. But see how this cuts out. And also, I have to tell you, use a strong mat. It does not have to be the purple mat, but it has to be probably the green mat. That's what I used. Or a brand new blue mat, and stick this down really hard. Poster board does not stick to the mats as well as paper. So I used a green mat, a used green mat, and it was just perfect. And I used the poster board setting. The poster board setting was perfect. I did not use the deep cut blade, I used the regular blade. And it was great, except for when I came down to here. That's why you can see some of these cut pieces, like it just doesn't look perfect. I should have cut it on poster board plus. These other pieces on regular poster board was fine, but when you get to more intricate design, you need poster board plus. And what that does is it just does a double cut. So it cuts it twice. So I'm gonna finish going over this one, and this is a Spectrum Noir or Spectrum Aqua. So it's watercolor marker. Not really sure if I should be using watercolor marker, but I am. And I am getting some of this on the front of this. Because this is watercolor, it seems to be wiping right off of the poster board, which maybe I should use that for the other piece too. Because it won't wipe off the paper part in the middle, but off the outside of the paper board, it wipes right off. That looks much better. Oh, and while I have this out, I'm gonna go ahead and do these. These are the shutters. I created these. The doghouse does not come with shutters. So if you're not using my file, you'd be like, what are those? And I don't know if you can see this. You see? I added score lines to make the shutters look like shutters. They're just score lines. You can only really see them on one side. Okay, I finished inking these all up and I did the windows. I messed up a little again too. But the shutters will be covering most of that up anyway. So let's go ahead and fold this. So you can see the score line here. We need to fold this down, and it's really easy to kind of see where the score lines are. And to score it properly, it's kind of hard because it's poster board. So the score line's here. You want to put like a thumb here and here, and you want to kind of be careful with it and just fold it like that. Okay. This one's going to be harder with the door. So just kind of fold one side at a time. There we go. You don't have to put really strong creases in it. And then we have the side. I'm not using a bone folder or anything on this. It does not need it. And then the top. Make sure you put your hand underneath it, like right where it folds, so you're not bending it where it doesn't want to be bent. And it'll get there. And it doesn't need to be folded all the way down. You only need it folded in a 90 degree angle. And then this one does not even need to be bent that far. I'm just going to kind of do it so it will bend in the right spot when it's time for it to bend. There. And I also had ideas. If you want to put candy or something in this box, you could put acetate over this, clear transparency or anything in here. You could cover up the windows and the door. I also thought if you put candy in it, you could put a little hole here for the candy to come out, but you would need like a little something sticking out here so it doesn't fall everywhere. And maybe I'll do that in another video. So we have that all folded. Oh, I didn't ink the edge of this one. Do that really fast. This is the roof. And we don't want to bend this down too far either. Just kind of so it knows where to bend. Okay, first thing we're gonna do is put the shutters on. Make sure you put the glue on side that does not have the score lines. This glue does take a little longer to dry on the poster board than it does on normal material. Oh no! I put them in the wrong spot. They go here. Good thing it doesn't dry so quickly on this material. Let's wipe this off with a baby wipe. Okay, now that's right. Make sure they're going this way with the side that goes like that. Okay, I'm leaving that mistake in there because that could totally happen to anybody, and I want you to be aware of it. Okay, I finally got the glue dry on the shutters, but it takes too long to dry, I think, for the other pieces. So I'm going to use this red line tape. This is really strong. It's double-sided tape, and I'm just going to put this perfect size. You peel away the red top. So it has a red piece that you peel that off, and then it's really, really strong sticky tape. So make sure you get it perfect. Put this flat on here. Line the score line here up to the bottom here, and then also the top score line. You want it just to the left of this score line here. There. We don't have to wait for no glue. Let's do that on this one. So we're gonna put that there, place that there, and then we're gonna line this up like we did on the other side. There we go. We're starting to see our doghouse. These are gonna go up like that. Believe me, they won't look this ugly when we're done. So I'm gonna go ahead and put tape on both of these sides and this side. So I'm going to do one side at a time. I have the red tape on there with the liner ripped off. And I'm going to line up the front. Then I'm going to line up the back. Just make sure their edges are lined up like that. And then I have the tape on here. If you can't get the red piece off, it's taking all the tape off. Just push it down a little harder and then it'll come off easier. Okay, I'm going to do one side at a time. Not bad. So now the bottom, you put this side down first, then these two sides, then this one you stick so it goes up in there. I think that's how you do it. I think that's how it goes. Okay, so now we need to fix this because that looks ugly. This goes on top of that. So that's going to go in there. But you know what? I forgot to stick this on. I should have done this before I put it all together just so it would stay better, but I'm going to go ahead and put this roof on. Okay, all I did was put glue there or tape there. Double-sided adhesive. Stuff's really strong. And I'm just going to put this down. And I want it to go over the edge on both sides. Maybe a little more in the front. Kind of looks like a birdhouse. Totally could be a birdhouse. I wonder if you put it outside if birds would use it. It'd get wet though, huh? In the rain. You might be able to put Mod Podge over it. Waterproof it. Okay, now I'm going to try the glue and stick this on. I think right there. You could, I was also thinking, you could have this right on here. You could put a name on here if you wanted. That would be really cute to have a name there. So I'm going to use glue, and I think right there. Does that look even? This glue does dry invisible. So there's the doghouse. I'm thinking you could put something up underneath here. Oh, you know what I wanted to do? I have these little butterflies. These are Epiphany Crafts, has these little stamps I got from HSN. I have round ones, and then I found these butterfly ones from Amazon, and they're so cool. I just punched these out with my digital paper. I was thinking I could add these to it. Ooh, I could add it to the roof, too. Isn't that pretty? Add some butterflies. Oh, wow. Okay, this is so cute. Okay, I'm going to use these little scotch little dots and stick these on with that. I'm going to stick one here. So cute! Okay, who knew a dog house would be this cute? Isn't that cute? I totally made these butterflies like 3 days ago just to make them. And I'm glad I did. Didn't know what I was going to do with them. Aren't they cute? Okay, now I need some help in the comments. Tell me what the heck to do with this. It's kind of big, but it's so cute. And this is so you can open it. So it's not completely closed. I could always use it to open it. I could stick a little light in there too. So cute. Isn't it cute? I love it. This could be little Pink Cricket's house, but she can't get inside. But she can fit inside. She could stand outside the door. So here's your doghouse/birdhouse. To be honest, I think it looks more like a birdhouse. Oh, maybe a birdhouse, this would be just a circle. That's how birdies go in. Yep, but I think this would work for a birdhouse too. Tell me what you guys think. So look in the description of the video for a link. So I'm gonna post this on the new Cricut's Primrose sharing site where you can share files. So I'll put a link to this project where you can make it also. There'll be a link in the description below and you can follow me on Primrose and get a few of my files there. All right guys, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video. Here's a shout out to a few of the people who support me on Patreon. Sandra, Ellen, Jennifer, Lynn, Bridgetta, Beth, Linda, Christine, Lynn, Tina, Misty, Heather, Alina, Brenda, Elizabeth, Janet, and Terry. Thanks guys.
You are watching Melody Lane. With me, you're gonna have a great crafting time.